Hi everyone, welcome to the third video in the quantitative methods series. In this video we'll be talking about how to work with variables in Stata. Specifically, we'll talk about how to generate new variables as well as how to replace information in existing variables. So again, opening up Stata, similar to what we had before, we'll first load up our original data set. This is the CompuStat data that we've been working with so far. And then when you want to generate new variables or replace information, as you might guess based on my phrasing, there's two key commands for this. The first being generate, or short gen in Stata, and the second being replace. So the former generates new variables, the latter replaces information in existing variables. And now we can use this in different ways. For example, we can just generate a new variable, which we will call constant. You can call it anything you want. And let's say we want this to equal 1. What this will do is generate a new variable that will equal 1 for all observations in our data set. That's this column that I just marked here. It's 1s across the data set. And indeed, if we tabulate it, you see that 100% of our data has a 1 for this variable. If you summarize it, you see the same. A bit more useful is that you can also generate variables based on information from other variables. So let's say, for example, we want to generate a new variable, let's call it time, which is the year minus 2010. This would mean that if we run it now, and if we tabulate it, you see it runs from 0 through 6. And this is because we generated this new variable, which will be 0 for the first year in our data set, which was 2010. Right? So you see in this column here, and any observation with a 0 for time, all of them are in the 2010 for the year variable. All those with a 1 for time have 2011 for the year variable, etc., etc. You can also generate variables in other ways. For example, we can generate one which is year times 100. That's what I just did here, right? Generate time 2, because we called it like that, equals year times 100. It could be anything we want. It could be any combination of variables as well. We could say year times cache, anything we want. So this generate command is really very flexible. Turning then to replacing information in existing variables. Let's work with this time variable that we just generated. And let's say we want to turn it back into the original year information. We can do so using the replace command, and we will say replace the time variable with the original time information, but we add 2010 again. If we do this and then we tabulate time, you see 2010 through 2016, similar to the year information. And indeed, if we cross-tabulate this, you can see now if a firm has a 2010 for the time variable, it will have a 2010 for the year variable in all cases. A bit more specific is that you can also replace information for variables for specific subsets of your observations. So for example, we can now turn back this time variable into what we had just now, but maybe only for some firms. So we can say replace time equals 0, but only if the year is exactly equal to 2010. So if we run this line here and then check the time variable, you see there's one set, which was those with 2010 for the year. And they have now a 0 for time, and the rest all still has this year that we had just now. Now we could go one by one for all the years and replace the time variable with the correct one. Or we could simply do another replace, which will replace all the observations for the time variable with year minus 2010. And this will be for all the observations. So you have to be a little bit careful with that sometimes, that you don't overwrite all the information. But nevertheless, given that we are working from a do file, you could always revert quite easily. So if we now check time, it should again be from 0 through 6. As we've seen a little bit already before, Stata can take different kinds of variables. Mostly we've been working with numeric for now, but you can also have string information being text. And the key commands for those two are toString and dstring, what we see here. Starting with the first, which is something that turns numbers into strings, the toString command will do this for any numeric variable. So we can say toString, the year variable, and we'll generate a new variable, which we will call year string. That's just something we named. We can name it anything we want. Another option would be to add, instead of generate, replace, and then it wouldn't require a variable name because it will overwrite the numeric year variable with string. So the year variable becomes string but replaces this original variable. So we will generate a new variable because we don't want to throw away information. And indeed, now if we tabulate this, you still see 2010 through 2016, but Stata is going to think that it's a string, right? So it won't be able to do anything more with it in terms of calculating. We can see this, for example, by using the summarize command. And Stata says there's no observations. And this is because it doesn't know how to calculate from text something like an average or standard deviation. To maybe illustrate it a little bit better, we can also tabulate the FIC variable, which, as you can maybe see here, contains text information on different countries. So for example, this one here would be Mexico, and there's 133 firms from Mexico. Of course, Stata is not able to calculate an average from this kind of variable, because you cannot calculate an average for text. Turning things the other way around, we can also turn now strings to numbers, and we will use the dstring command for that. Similar to the toString command, it's just saying dstring, and now we say the year string variable that we just generated, and we'll generate a new variable called year numeric. This only works if the string information contains numbers, just like what we saw for years. We would be able to say these are numbers as well, right? So if we now go to tab, we can see these are numbers. But now Stata also knows it's a number, and therefore it can calculate averages. If we try to do the same for the country information, Stata will give you an error. It says contains non-numeric characters, no generate. So it doesn't know how to turn these countries into numbers. We need to be a little bit more specific with what we want to do. For this purpose, there's the encode command. And that command will be able to say, okay, for every country in the order that it appears in here, so alphabetically, it will assign a number to it. So we will generate a new variable, which we call FIC numeric. And if we run this, we will see a new variable at the end of our data set, which will contain all the numbers, and the numbers correspond to the countries. I just added the no label option to the tabulate, so that shows the raw numbers. And if I just now tabulate the newly generated variable, you see the text labels assigned to it. But Stata now knows group one is Argentina, and the last group is ZAF. So now Stata knows these texts belong to a specific number that we just generated. Another option that you have for turning strings into numbers is to just use the tabulate command with the option generate added. Whereas what we just did with encode generates a single variable which contains a label and a number for every unique value, the tabulate command will generate a whole range of new variables for every unique group. And just showing that here, you'll see it will tabulate what we had before, but now in our variable overview, we see 57 newly generated variables. And as we'll see in the next video, that will have different implications for how we can use them. Other transformations that are quite common, and those are also the ones we will discuss in class. One is a log transformation, which basically pulls the very large values inwards. Has some downsides. It cannot take negative values, it cannot take zeros. So if we run this, for example, on the cache variable, saying we want to generate, which we will call lnch, which is the log, natural log of the ch variable. If we run this, you will see Stata say it had 17,000 missing values. That's because of what I just mentioned. And also because cache had some missing information, as we saw in the last video. An alternative that we'll also discuss in class is the kubeproot transformation. It does not have this downside of not being able to take zeros, not being able to take negative numbers. It's this whole difficult command here. We'll discuss in class exactly why this is the way it is, but basically it's taking cache to the powers 1/3. And if we generate this, you see indeed Stata has fewer missing values. So these are really the ones that have cache missing. You cannot calculate anything from that. Another one would be the exponential. Again, something we'll discuss in class, but if you want to generate it, it's as follows. Generate expch is the exponential of ch. Finally, the last thing I'll show is that you can add labels to variables. So for example, we had this time variable, right, which was year minus 2010. That might not be self-evident if we just generate it, and then we might forget about it if we don't keep good track of what we did. So it might be good to just add a label. So now we say we want to add label to a variable called time, right? That's the time is the one we have the name for. We can replace the name. And then between these quotes, we put the name that we want to give the variable. In this case, we say year minus 2010. And if we tabulate time now, you see here in the top right, the label that we had assigned to this variable. Finally, you can also assign labels to specific values. Right now in this tabulate, you still see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We can also take these two steps here that I'll walk you through to assign values or labels to specific values. Let's label define, and then we say a new name, we say time label. So again, this can be anything we want. And then we say for the value 0, we want to have this piece of text. For the value 1, we want to have this piece of text, etc., etc. So we run that first. If we tabulate time right now, it won't be updated yet because we still have to apply this label. So if we now type label values and then time label, what this means is we want to label the values for the time variable with the time label that we just had. It's a bit of a roundabout way, but that's the way state works, unfortunately. If we run that now and then tabulate time, you see here the labels we just applied. So the variable label as well as the value label. If we now tabulate time with the option no label, we see kind of the underlying data. So this would be, if we put this into a model, this is what goes in, because these are the numbers behind the labels. That's all I wanted to talk about for generating and replacing information from variables. In the next video, I'll talk a bit about bivariate relationships, so relationships between two variables. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.